Approximately 90 million years ago, a shield volcano off the western coast of the nation of Colombia produced a strange geologic phenomenon. This volcano erupted, but instead of producing slow-moving basaltic lava flows, it began ejecting large volumes of a water-like substance. This substance was in fact a variety of lava which had not erupted in more than 2 billion years and quickly flowed downslope like a waterfall at speeds exceeding 100 kilometers or 60 miles per hour. This buried the landscape in an unusually thin coating of lava which was as little as a centimeter thick. After the eruption ended, the lava cooled with an unusual group of plate-like olivine crystals. This crystal structure is referred to as a Spinifex structure, which is a defining feature of very rare komatiite lavas. These water-like komatiite lavas have not erupted since, as the geologic setting used to produce them no longer exists. So, why did komatiites used to commonly erupt? Where can these rocks be found today? This video will answer these two questions and discuss a very rare type of lava. When komatiite lavas erupted, they flowed onto the surface at higher temperatures than any lava flow seen in modern times. Generally speaking, as the silica content within lava increases, the temperature of it decreases. This is why rhyolite is measured at temperatures as low as 650 degrees Celsius, and basalt lava is measured at temperatures as high as 1250 degrees Celsius. In contrast, komatiite lavas were between 1300 and 1600 degrees Celsius and were unusually enriched in magnesium oxide, which composed at least 18% of their volume by weight. This unusual composition was made possible by the Earth's mantle, which was 100 to 250 degrees Celsius warmer during the Archean period than it is today. Between 2.5 and 4 billion years ago, the planet's mantle was hotter due to a higher abundance of radioactive isotopes which have largely since decayed, and a greater residual heat from planetary accretion. This unusually warm mantle caused unusually high degrees of partial melting, resulting in an abundance of high magnesium and low potassium, as the two are considered incompatible elements. During the Archean period, komatiites were very widespread on the planet, comprising large swaths of the planet's oceanic crust. New oceanic crust forms through the spreading of two tectonic plates, allowing for silica-poor mantle-rich molten rock to erupt onto the surface. Due to the lower temperature of the modern mantle, komatiite lavas have been replaced with basalt in the vast depths of the oceans. Komatiites almost universally erupted from ancient fissure systems or shield volcanoes which built flatter profiles than seen today. Individual lava flows could easily travel 30 kilometers or more distant, resulting in thin coatings of lava over a large area, much like a layer of snow. Because this variety of lava left behind such thin coatings of material, what komatiites we see today represents lava deposited in low points which pooled, such as sinkholes, rivers, and lava tubes. The lava's unusually fast speed was owed due to its low viscosity, which was 100 times lower than that of modern basalt. While basalt has a viscosity similar to that of ketchup, komatiite has a viscosity similar to maple syrup. This unusually low viscosity was caused by its low silica content, as silica tends to form long chains that stick together, which impedes overall movement. While you can easily outrun or even outwalk almost every lava flow in existence, you might not have been able to outdrive komatiite lavas in a vehicle. While komatiite lava no longer erupts, a place on the planet exists where a volcano erupts lava with a similar viscosity. At Old Yanyolengai in Tanzania, natural carbonatite black lava has about twice the viscosity of komatiite, and it truly flows more like water than typical molten rock. Due to plate subduction and other processes, very few locations exist on the planet where large sections of the crust are older than 2.5 billion years in age, which have komatiites. However, large stable sections of the crust called cratons with komatiite exist in Western Australia, Manitoba in Canada, and Eastern South Africa. If you happen to find some of these rare rocks, consider yourself lucky. Not only are they unusually old, but they are frequently associated with Archean nickel and gold deposits. Thanks for watching. If you'd like to request a specific topic, please leave a comment below. Additionally, I would like to thank my new patron Eric Rohn for supporting this channel.